Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about craniocervical junction and jewelry imaging. Definition: craniocervical junction injury is a traumatic injury to upper cervical region, occiput to C2, much more common in first decade than in 10th order. Most common sign symptom, AOD, mainly die prior to reach medical care. More than half have cardiorespiratory arrest, 25 to 30% are neurological intact at presentation. Jefferson fracture, axial loading injury, diving into swallow pool, odontoid and hangman fracture, flexion or extension with destruction. Rotational injury, present with painful torticollis, plus minus delay presentation after trauma, may have little or no trauma antecedent. Demographic: A, 0 to 9 years, high incidence of upper cervical spine injury compared to adolescent and adult, disproportionate head size, ligamentous laxity, and immature muscle have all been postulated as causes. Gender: predominantly male. In adolescent and teens, epidemiology: 5% of spinal injury occur in children, 18 to 21 over 1 million population. Imaging: normal measurement in adult may not translate to child due to dynamic skeletal change in earlier life. Radiograph: initial screening test for most children. More than 20% of cervical fracture are missed by radiography alone. 10% of craniocervical junction fracture are shown by CT, not radiography. CT, asymmetry and increased joint space measurement. CT, look for retrocleaval hematoma and perimedullary hemorrhage. T2 for ligament integrity and cord edema. Steel for bone marrow and soft tissue edema. SWI or T2 star. G or E for cord hemorrhage. MIA, vertebral arterial injury, may be associated with CCJ injury, often clinically occult. This is bone CT in a 9-year-old girl after motor vehicle accident, so increase of the condylar C1 interval as well as lateral mass interval consistent with severe atlanto-occipital dislocation and atlanto-axial disassociation. Still am I in the same patient, so disruption of the tectorial membrane and transection of the posterior atlanto-occipital ligament, the spinal cord, so hyperintense signal, as well as shoe pussy of low signal. This is non-contrasting MCT in a 7-year-old boy involved in a motor vehicle accident, so a retrocleaval epidural hematoma. Such a finding should prompt image investigate for craniocervical injury. CMR in the same patient, so effusion in the bilateral occipital condyle and atlantum oxygen joint, as well as disruption of the life transfer ligament. Also note the extension of fluid beyond the left OCC1 joint capsule, consistent with capsular rupture. These findings are consistent with AOD. This is the frontal open mouth radiograph in a 17 years old girl who fell from performing a back flip. So the C1 lateral mass extending lateral to the C2 lateral mass, as well as widening of the lateral atlantodental space, consistent with Jefferson fracture. Non-contrasting NCT in the same patient, so a displaced fracture of the right anterior arch of C1, a non-displaced fracture of the left posterior arch of C1, and a posterior cortical eversion fracture of the left anterior arch of C1. Treatment support of impaired system function, stabilization of spine to prevent further injury, internal or external surgical stabilization, identification of extent of fracture or injury, imaging decompression of spinal cord impingement, administration of steroid for acute spinal cord injury, is controversial. Intensive rehabilitation beginning shortly after treatment conclude. Thank you.